Hello and welcome to all for today's lecture on electric circuit analysis 2. The topic for today's lecture is three phase AC circuits. So, after this lecture, the objective of this lecture is the student will be able to generate three phase balanced voltages. The student will be able to represent three phase balanced voltages and three phase balanced currents in both waveform, analytical and mathematical form as well as phasor form. So, you will be able to draw the phasor diagram of the three phase balanced AC networks. And you will understand what is the meaning of phase sequence, what is the meaning of neutral current, what is the significance of positive phase sequence and negative phase sequence. So, let us move in. So, first of all, the first term of three phase AC circuits was introduced by John Hopkinson in 1882. Electric power generation and transmission and distribution across the globe takes place in the form of three phase AC circuits. A three phase AC system consists basically of three phase generators, three phase transmission system, transformers and three phase loads. Okay. So, why do we need to go for three phase system? What are the benefits of three phase system over a single phase system? In a three phase system, the rating of the system is high when compared to the single phase system for a given material. So, more the number of phases, more will be the efficiency and more will be the rating of the machine. The total instantaneous power is constant. In case of a single phase AC circuit, it is observed that the total power is continuously pulsating, whereas in case of a three phase circuit, the output power is constant and therefore, the torque will be constant and it will cause less vibrations when it is connected to the three phase rotating machines. And power transmission economics, we know that whenever the power is transmitted at high voltages, the amount of material that is required for the conductor or copper will be reduced and the transmission economics will be improved. So, here you can see the generation of three phase balanced voltages. For that, you basically require this kind of a setup where you have a pole here, a salient pole here and a armature here. Okay. A three windings are placed here, so which are mutually 120 degrees from away from each other. So, see here, this is one phase winding R, this is another phase winding B and B dash and Y and Y dash. So, here three windings are there such that they are electrically displaced from each other by 120 degrees. Clear. So, there are three windings on the stator and poles on the rotor. Equal number of turns are available, equal number of windings on all the three windings, equal number of turns are there, that is to produce three phase balanced voltages and equal voltage in magnitude in all the three phases. These are the conditions for balanced systems. The windings are displaced at electrically from an angle of 120 degrees from each other. It can be seen in this diagram. The three phase voltages in each phase are also at an angle of 120 degrees from each other. So, here there are three windings, a winding R and it is having two terminals here, terminal R and terminal R dash. Similarly, you have another winding here, Y and Y dash, another winding B and B dash. Now, all these three terminals B dash, Y dash and R dash are joined together to form one common terminal. Here you can see it is connected here as a to the neutral. So, here three phase windings, all these three are connected such that they are having one common terminal. Clear? So, with such kind of a setup, a three phase AC generator which is called a synchronous generator will produce three voltages where the three phases are given as V R N, V Y N and V B N. So, V R is mathematically written as V M sin omega t. In phasor form, you can write it as V at an angle 0. Similarly, V Y, it is having same magnitude as the voltage R, but it is lagging the voltage by an angle 120 degrees. Similarly, V B, which is lagging the voltage by 240, the reference voltage V R by an angle 240 degrees. Clear? So, this is how you represent them mathematically. Here the phase sequence is assumed as R, Y, B. That means, initially R voltage is generated followed by Y and then B. So, in a waveform, in a graphical form, here you can see in this graph, On the y-axis, you have the voltages, three voltages, VA, VR, VY and VB. And you have on the x-axis, you have an angle 30 degrees, 60 degrees, 90 degrees and so on. If you plot this equation, you will get a graph in this red color which indicates this voltage VR. Similarly, you take the second equation, Vm sin omega t minus 120, you plot a graph, you will get a curve in yellow color. Similarly, you take the third equation and draw it, you will get the blue color curve. So here, initially R phase is coming, followed by Y phase, and then followed by B phase voltage. So that is why the phase sequence is R, Y and B. This is the three phase voltage waveform. This is the mathematical representation of the three phase voltages. Similarly, we will see what are the three phase currents. For that, we assume a balanced load of three phases, that is three star connected load Z having an impedance Z is connected to the three phase sources. Suppose this is point A, it is connected to phase A of the load. This is point B, it is connected to node B of the load. This is point C and this is connected to point C of the load, and these common points are joined together. Now if you observe any loop here, it is indicated by this dotted lines. The current flowing in this loop is given as IR. It is flowing from VRN and then it is flowing through the load through the common point it is threatening. Similarly, you see this yellow color current, it is flowing through the load and it is coming to the source VYN. Similarly, this blue color, you can see the current is flowing like this, it is flowing to the source and threatening to the common neutral point. So here the ratio of the voltage upon impedance is nothing but the current. Suppose you want current IR, it is VR by impedance Z. So Z is written as Z at an angle theta. Z is written as Z at an angle theta. So V at an angle 0 by Z at an angle theta. So here in complex, you can see any value in the denominator, if it is coming up, so here you can see it is written as IR is I at an angle minus theta. Similarly, you see IY, it is written by VY by impedance Z. It is the ratio of voltage by impedance Z. So here the voltage VR is given as V at an angle theta, impedance is Z. Any value, any angle in the denominator, when it comes to the numerator, it is written as minus theta. Therefore, the value of current is I at an angle minus theta, where I is given by ratio of voltage by impedance Z. Similarly, you see the current IY, it is ratio of VY by Z. So VY is V at an angle minus 120 upon Z. So it will give you I at an angle minus 120. This will come to the numerator, therefore minus theta. So it can be written as I at an angle minus 120 minus theta. Similarly, IB, the third phase, VB by Z. So it will give you I at an angle 120 minus theta. So it is observed that all the three phases is having a current that is equal to V by Z, but they are phase displaced by an angle of 120 degrees from each other. They are phase displaced by an angle of 120 degrees from each other. Now we see the phasor diagram of the three phase balanced AC circuit. Assume a star star load, and here the voltage and the current phasors are drawn for a lagging type of load. The impedance angle is assumed to be theta lagging. So initially, on a horizontal xy plane, you take a horizontal xy plane, draw a horizontal axis which will give represent the voltage phasor VR. It will represent the voltage phasor VR. Followed by this, any phasor that is drawn above this, any phasor that is drawn above this will have a positive angle, and any phasor drawn below this will have a negative angle. Clear? So see here. So we have to draw the voltage VB. What is the voltage VB? VB is equal to V at an angle minus 120 degrees. So if you have to draw VB, first of all, from here you take an angle of 120 degrees, minus 120 degrees below this. and draw another phasor which represents the voltage Vy. Similarly, Vb is at an angle plus 120 degrees. This is plus 120 degrees with respect to Vr. This is minus 120 degrees with respect to Vr. So, all these three phases are mutually at 120 degrees with respect to each other. Now, we have to draw the current phasors. So, what is the value of current phasor? The current in the phase R, current in the phase R is Ir, is nothing but it is having a magnitude I, but it is at an angle minus theta. So, take an angle minus theta from the reference and there you draw the phasor for the current Ir, which is having a magnitude I, but it is lagging the reference by an angle theta. Clear? Similarly, you have to draw Ib. What is Ib? Ib should lag Iy should lag Vy by an angle theta. So, here this phasor will give Iy. Similarly, you take the another phasor which is lagging Vb by an angle minus theta. So, you will get this is the current Ib. So, here R, Y and B. These are the three phase currents and three phase voltages in the represented by the phasor diagram for a three phase star star circuit. Next, what is the meaning of neutral? Neutral means all the common points are connected to one common point that is grounded, which is called as neutral. So, we can connect the negative ends of the three single phase generators and the loads together to share a common return line which is connected to the ground is called as neutral. So, here in this diagram which you have seen earlier, this is the common point of all the three sources. This is the common point of all the three loads. If these two are joined together, these terminals are called as neutral or ground, and there is the current that is flowing through this is called neutral current, which is under ideal conditions is always equal to 0 for a balanced circuit. Now, we have to prove that the value of neutral current is equal to 0. So, applying KCL, the neutral current is sum of all the three phase currents IR plus IY plus IB. So, IR can be written as I at an angle minus theta, IY can be written as I at an angle minus theta minus 120, IB can be written as I at an angle minus theta minus 240. So, further simplifying this, you can take out I at an angle minus theta and represent I at an angle minus theta into I at an angle minus 0 degrees. Similarly, the second term can be written as I at an angle minus theta into I at an angle minus 120. Similar third term can be written as I at an angle minus theta into I at an angle minus 240, and you take out I into theta from this common, the summation of these three phasors, I at an angle 0 plus I at an angle minus 120 plus I at an angle minus 240 will be resolved to be 0, and finally, you will get the neutral current is 0. So, under balanced condition, the neutral current is always 0. So, in a balanced three phase system, the neutral is not necessary. So, as long as the three loads are equal, the current in the neutral is 0. So, a three phase power system will have equal magnitude. Three phased balanced power system will have equal magnitude, equal phase difference, identical loads is called as a balanced three phase system. So, in a balanced three phase system, we can omit the neutral. Next, what is the meaning of phase sequence? The phase sequence is the order in which the voltages attains their peak value is called as phase sequence. Phase sequence is the sequence in which the vectors pass through a fixed point in space when they are rotated in a particular direction. So, here let us see what is the phase sequence. Here from the waveform we can see that initially this is phase R which is attaining the maximum voltage, followed by phase Y and followed by phase B. These are the three phase voltages. You can see the phase sequence is R followed by Y and followed by B. So, the phase sequence is R, Y, B. But if you take it from here, if you initially take from this point, initially Y is big, then followed by B attains its peak value and then R. So, Y, B, R. Or if you start from here, you will get it as B, R, Y. In any case, all these three phase sequences the same, that is R, Y, B or Y, B, R or B, R, Y. You can call it as the same. Next. if you assume that these are three phasors that are rotating in counterclockwise direction at a constant speed, and here is an imaginary viewer, we are seeing this. So if these three phasors are rotating with constant angular velocity, this imaginary viewer will see first Vr, after 120 degrees rotation he will see Vy, and after 120 degrees rotation, further 120 degrees rotation, he will see Vb. So the phase sequences are Yb. This sequence is usually assumed to be a positive phase sequence. Now we see what is negative phase sequence. Here you see the phasor diagram again, initially R phase followed by you have R phase followed by B phase followed by Y phase. So the phase sequence is R, B, Y. Here you see this phasor diagram, here an imaginary viewer, he will see R phase, all the phasors are rotating in counterclockwise direction, followed by B phase and then followed by Y phase. So phase sequence is R, B, Y or B, Y, R or R, Y, B, all these three are same. This phase sequence is called a negative phase sequence. Now what is the significance of this phase sequence? Why do we need to study this phase sequence? If you see in a three phase AC motor applications, suppose you assume that this is three phase AC motor, it is having three phases, phase A, phase B and phase C, and you have a three phase supply, phase A, phase B and phase C. If you connect the phase A to A, phase B to B and phase C to C, the motor will rotate in a particular direction. However, If you interchange this A point to B, if you connect point A to capital B and node A here, if you interchange this connection, you will observe that the direction of rotation of this motor is changing. So in such kind of applications, it is very important to measure what is the phase sequence before connecting them to the supply. Similarly, in case of three phase alternators which are operating in parallel, it is observed that the phase sequence must be measured before synchronizing the alternators. So here we have studied about what is positive phase sequence, what is negative phase sequence. Positive phase sequence is RYB and negative phase sequence is RBY. So in this particular class, we have studied how to represent what are three phase voltages, how to represent them in mathematical form, in phasor form and also in waveforms. We have studied about what is the significance of phase sequence, what are the types of phase sequence. Thank you. So what is the significance of phase sequence, positive phase sequence and negative phase sequence, and what is its importance? For further understanding, you can go through these videos where how a basic three phase electricity is produced and how, what is the significance of three phase sequence RYB or YBR, it's explained. And for further questioning, so here these are some basic questions. What is phase sequence and what is it important in application? What do you mean by positive and negative phase sequence? What is voltage and frequency in a three phase system? How do you measure the three phase sequence? So these are some questions that you can follow through for better understanding. Thank you.